Hi guys, we're here at Care Park this week, bringing another round of Madcap Zany Madness with your two favorite coaches. Unfortunately, they couldn't be here, so you're stuck with us. Tim?
Oh, we still miss all you guys. We really hope to come back soon. Unfortunately, the date has been pushed back even farther. This coronavirus is, no one knows. So anyway, we're gonna come back. May 15th is now the return date. Long time, so you better be practicing at home. We're gonna show you some more skills out here. Hope you have a wonderful Easter, everyone. Happy Easter.
Guys, today we got a story for you about a bad ball club that turned good in the end. When you're watching this video, don't do what they did at the beginning. Watch how they played at the end.
Happy Easter, everyone. Have a good weekend.
Here's the story of a bunch of players. In the field, each boy did what he desired. Not one of them would ever watch the batter, so the coach grew very tired. It's the story of a coach gone crazy, trying to get his team to win just one game. They were 9 players, grouping off together, so they were very lame. There was one boy playing cards next to the golfer, and the shortstop deferred to take a call. And the boy at third was scuba diving, and we don't know what the outfield did at all. The bad ball club, the bad ball club. That's the way they became a bad ball club. Till the one day when the coach had a meltdown, and they knew that they'd really better try. They focused and got their act together, so the coach would cease to cry. They were 9 guys working all together. They began to win and defeated all their foes.
Hey, nice
now
catch out there.
Face,
that's more like it.
It was very happy.
All right. Yeah.
You'd even
take
say
two,
it glows.
Probably turn 2.
So
way to go,
our boys
guys.
Are now
good
the
job.
Rulers of the ball field. And the
nice
right fielder
catch.
No longer
quick, quick,
takes
quick
a break.
Attaboy.
We're shooting
nice.
Two all around
good
the diamond. And we're learning teamwork is a piece of cake. A good ball club.
Oh,
a good ball club.
Oh, yeah.
That's the way they became a good ball club.
Welcome back, everyone. This is our third week of the Easter Story Club meeting. But before we get started, I have a couple videos I want to share with you from some of your friends. So check it out. Hope you enjoy the videos. If you guys want to be in the video next week, send me your videos to the email right here. And we'll be sure to include those videos in next week's broadcast. Now we're going to kick it off to Mr. Chang with a little Easter greeting and followed by Mr. Ixta.
Hey guys, Coach Chang here. I know some of you may have forgotten my name, but I just wanted to say hi and happy Easter, especially to my Jaguars, okay? I miss you guys and just hope you guys are doing well, staying healthy, being able to have fun inside even. So I want to say hi to Richard, Damien, Vincent, Jaden, Elijah, Nikolai, Isaac, Christian, Frankie, Dante, Andrew, Anthony, and Lucas. All right, happy Easter, guys.
Hi, it's Coach Ixta. Here to wish you a happy Easter. It's a great day because he is risen. Hoping you're spending a fun day today with your family. And stay safe out there. Can't wait to see you guys. I miss you. Stay safe so we can play some baseball soon. All right. Bye.
Last week we had 3 questions. And sent those out. And Ben, once again, answered all 3 questions. And here's his video.
Hi.
Okay.
Thank you for all the videos. They were so great. I read my Bible today and I found all the answers to all the questions. The first question is that I answered that was really easy was, which garden did Jesus pray in? And it was Gethsemane. Gethsemane. The second one that I answered was the sign above Jesus' head. And it was, this is the King of the Jews. And the third one was, Jesus told a criminal. The criminal. Today, you will be with me in paradise.
All right, boys, it's time to finish the Easter story. To start off, we're going to go back to the part where Jesus was having the Passover supper with his friends. I got my Welch's grape juice here and my bread. And that, again, represents Jesus' body, the bread, and the juice represents his blood. And remember in the story last week, he was taken off and killed on a cross. Well, we're going to get to that. Back to the eggs, though. Remember after the garden, after the Passover dinner, they went to the garden to pray, and that was the hands, remember that? Okay, and then Judas, remember the bad guy? Yeah, Judas betrayed Jesus. They come, they capture him, and who remembers what Peter did? Yeah, he got the sword, boom, that was cool. All right, well, Peter, you know, he later on denied Jesus three times. Remember, we talked about that with the rooster crowing. They got Jesus, they captured him, took him to a guy named Pontius Pilate. And Pilate basically washed his hands of it, said, I don't want anything to do with this guy. But he did order for Jesus to be killed. So they took him away, took him up to the hill, and they nailed him to a cross. And you guys remember the part about the criminals on the cross, and one of them made fun of Jesus, and the other one said, this guy's done nothing wrong. And eventually, remember the video about Ben? Yeah, the answer to the question was, what did Jesus say to this guy? And he said, today you will be with me in paradise. Okay. Well, after that, they took Jesus' body down. He did die. And that was the sad part. But remember, this is not over. Today's the cool part. They took Jesus down. They put him in a tomb, in a big cave. Okay? And they took Jesus, and they put, in front of the cave, they put a big rock. And remember the bad guys? They actually came, and they put soldiers in front of the grave. Because they didn't want anyone taking the body out and pretending like, oh, he rose and lying about it. Well, this part's pretty cool. After that, Jesus, he was in the tomb for a while, but an angel came. And an angel appeared to the soldiers in front of the rock. And they're like, freaking out. Whoa! And they ran away. And the angel pushed the rock away. Jesus comes out. And he's alive. Jesus is alive. He's alive today. It's an awesome story. Well, at that same time, Mary, not his mother, but Mary Magdalene, she was going to visit the grave and, you know, to weep. And she went to the grave and she saw the rock pushed away. And she's like, what happened? She went inside. And inside, our last Easter egg is empty. Because the tomb was empty. Today, in churches across the nation, because of the coronavirus, churches are empty. But guess what? Jesus is alive. The grave might be empty, but Jesus is alive. All right. So, moving on in the story. After that, Mary, you know, she's like, what's going on? And there happened to be like a gardener there. And she's like, sir, what happened? And this gardener told her what happened. Well, the gardener was actually Jesus. And after that, Jesus, he visited with some of his friends, the disciples. He told them, I'm alive. He showed them the holes in his hands. There's a story about Jesus walking down the trail with some people. They didn't even know it was Jesus at the time. They didn't recognize him. Eventually, he disappeared. They're like, whoa, that was Jesus. He was with us this whole time. There's another story about they were all really scared because remember the bad guys are still trying to get all the disciples. They were hiding in the secret room. Well, Jesus just appeared to them out of, you know, the doors were locked and windows, but Jesus just appeared to them. And he said, "It is me, I've risen." One of them wasn't there, Thomas, later on. He didn't believe it, and Jesus actually had to show him, you know, put your fingers in my hands, show you the holes in my hands. I'm alive! Woo! So Jesus, he was risen. This little baby right here, the baby Jesus. Yeah, Jesus, he grew up to be a man. And that brings us to the point, why did he have to do all this? Why did he go to a cross and die? It doesn't even make sense. Well, he did it to take the sin out of our heart. But, like, what's sin? What does that even mean? Well, sin, it came to the earth with this guy. Who remembers the story of the snake in the Garden of Eden? Yeah. Adam and Eve, they lived in paradise. Beautiful place. No sin, nothing bad. It was perfect. Well, then the devil, the snake, came and said, Hey, Eve, why don't you eat this fruit? And when she ate of that fruit from the tree of the knowledge of good and evil, and then she gave it to Adam and he ate it, sin came into their hearts, okay? And sin entered the world. But specifically, what is sin? Like, I don't know what that, do you guys know what that means? Well, let's talk about it. So I got my heart here, okay? And I know this is kind of old, I've been using it for years. But this heart represents what is inside of us. So when we're born, when we're babies, unfortunately, we like to tell lies. Okay, I do. I used to tell lies all the time. Okay, and so we have that in us. We tell lies. Maybe some of you, maybe you're a stealer. You like to steal things. Ooh, ooh. How about this one? Cheater, pumpkin eater. Yeah, I used to cheat too, especially in school. Don't do that though. You don't want to cheat. Maybe you're selfish. Don't be selfish, right? Well, all this stuff is bad stuff, and it's in your heart. You can't stop it. You can't prevent it. Only one person can stop you from doing all the bad stuff, and guess who that is? It's Jesus. And this is why God sent Jesus to the earth. He sent him so you don't have to be a liar, pants on fire anymore, okay? You don't have to be a cheater, pumpkin eater anymore, okay? He came to take the stuff out of your heart, okay? And when he died on that cross and he rose, remember that the tomb was empty? He wasn't there anymore. What was he doing? Where did he go? Okay, well, you know what he did? He actually conquered the grave. That means he told the devil, "You can't have my friends anymore. If they believe in me and they want me to come in their heart, they get to go to heaven." And you know what he did? He actually, after he talked to his disciples and, you know, told them to go into the earth, the world, and spread the gospel and spread the message, he went to heaven. Okay, and he's there right now. He's sitting at the throne of heaven right now. And you know what he did? He unlocked the gates to heaven. Okay. In fact, the only way to get to heaven is because Jesus is the key. He's the key to get to heaven. It's like, you know, I got a key to start my car. Okay. Well, you can't open the door to heaven unless Jesus is your key. Okay. And Jesus has to come and take the bad stuff out. So let's finish the heart here. He could come in. He could take all this stuff out of your heart. He wants to take it all out. He wants to take it all out. But let's say, let's put the lying back in. Maybe you like to lie, you know. You're a liar, pants on fire. And maybe all this other stuff, yeah, we could get rid of it. But I like to keep my lying pants. You know, I like to keep my lying. So maybe I'll just do little white lies here and there. And God will still love me. Maybe. Well, Jesus, he wants to give you a new heart. And again, this is the only way you get to go to heaven. So he wants to give you a new heart. And unfortunately, it won't fit. You can't get a new heart unless you let Jesus take all of that bad stuff out. You got to confess your sins. You got to pray. You got to believe and receive. Okay? That's the easy three steps. Okay? And he'll take all of that bad stuff out of your heart. He'll give you a brand new heart. Amazing. And then you have a new heart. And God's taking all that sin out. And again, this is the whole Easter story. Why did Jesus come? Okay? Why did he let people spit on him and make fun of him and beat him, put a crown of thorns on his head and put holes in his hands and nail him to the cross? Why did he let him do it? He did it to get rid of this guy, to get rid of sin in your heart. He did it to take the sin out of your heart. You can't do it on your own. I can't do it on my own. The only way to do it is to ask Jesus to do it. And guess what? He already did it. He already did it for you. You just have to accept it. And all you got to do is pray and say, "Jesus, I'm so glad you died on the cross for me. Thank you for Easter. Thank you for coming to the world. Thank you for dying on a cross. I believe it, Lord, and I accept your salvation, Lord. I accept the fact that you could come into my heart and pull out all that sin, and I want to be a follower of Jesus. And if you could say that prayer and you really mean it, Jesus could come in your heart. And he gets to open the gates to heaven for you. Because again, Jesus is the key. So thank you very much. Hope you enjoy this Easter season. Have a wonderful day, everybody. See ya.